From the NTV Film Library, we'd like to present this 1958 black and white coverage of a hockey game at the St. John's Memorial Stadium between Grand Falls and St. John's. The play-by-play announcer is Bill Callahan, later publisher of the St. John's Daily News.
And just so, couldn't clear Withers in front again, and he couldn't get his pass away. In the corner, it rolls to the back of the net. McGinnis swept it around. Gesso took over and left it go to Collins. Collins at center, ahead to Alex Faulkner. Faulkner in over the line, and he's turned around. It's Collins trying to get a shot. He can't. Rolling had a try. Lenny Faulkner shoots, and he scores! 1-0, Grand Falls leading, and we've played 6.5 minutes of the first period. The face-off to the left of Merv Green in St. John's territory. Referee Gordon Osworthy ready to drop in the puck, and there's a slight delay. Now they do. It's Buckner trying to get a shot away. It's wide to the corner. Burns will be in for it with Collins on the board. It's held in, and still on. He gets it ahead to Gooby at center, over to Clark. He rolled in and over the line, and nobody was there to get it, and Lenny Faulkner clears it to the line and out. Now it's Terry Gesso, the big defenseman, starting out at the St. John's line, a real drive. And it went by the pipe to the left of Merv Green, and Max Howell starts to carry it out. It's Howell coming down to his own line, ahead to Rolly Clark, and he couldn't catch the pass from Howell, and it's cleared out to center ice again. Now it rolls all the way back into St. John's territory. Lenny Faulkner back and couldn't get to it. Now it's Collins right in front of backhander. And it was high over the net. And Clark clears back to Gooby again at the line. It's Gooby starting out at center ice. And he couldn't get by Harvey Thomas. And Lenny Faulkner takes over for Grand Falls. On the wing, a shot. And it's just wide. And Lloyd Cook recovers for the Capitals. He couldn't clear it. Goes in front. Lenny Faulkner getting set. And he rolled a weak one. And Max Howell clears it out again. Warren England backhanded it down the ice, and Steve Thomas gets it at his own line. It rolls loose at center ice to Alex Faulkner, starting in over the St. John's line, and Howell stopped him and rolled it out to center again, and Bill Gillis got it there and fired it all the way down the ice, and St. John's will be called for icing. Grand Falls territory, the Capitals having a couple of good chances, and each time they fired it right by the goal. In the corner, Lloyd Cook turns Harvey House around. It comes out to center. Len Coughlin has it. Coughlin ahead to Bill Gillis on the wing. He turned it out, and nobody could get to it. And Bucky Hannaford got it, and Coughlin stopped him. Now it's Cook shooting it in again. Steve Thomas clears it out and down the ice into St. John's territory with Hugh Fardy back to get it. Fardy going around the net. He's being chased by Hubert Green, who couldn't catch up to him. Now it's Hannaford at center. Fardy took it from him and starts out again. He shoots it in over the Grand Falls line to the corner. Mike Woodford back for it. He couldn't reach it. And it comes all the way out to center once more, and Coughlin has it there. Coughlin fired it ahead to Woodford. He overskated it. And it's loose at center ice. Collins couldn't handle it. Hannaford got to it. And now it's Farrell steering it in over the Grand Falls line. He was turned around and couldn't hang on. Right in front. And Mike Woodford was on the doorstep and couldn't do anything with it. Now it's Hannaford on the wing, going in fast, and he's stopped by Gooby. Gooby in the corner, trying to clear, finally does ahead to Sparrow. Sparrow's starting out with Gillis, and his shot, or his pass, was deflected back into Capitals territory, and Gooby has it there as they change on the fly. It's Gillis on the wing. Couldn't get past Thomas, who dumped him. Sparrow rolled it in over the line, and it rolls loose. It comes out to the line again. Gooby getting to it, had a drive. And Grillo clears it to center ice. Grillo and Gooby bump on the boards. It rolls all the way down to the corner to the left of Merv Green with Max Powell trying to clear. On the wing still, Woodford couldn't clear it. Collins has it behind the net. He's bumped by Gillis. The sticks go high and he starts swinging. And there's a whistle on the play. We'll have to wait and see what happens. And we'll have the first penalty of the game to Colby Collins of Grand Falls. On the board, Terry Gesso throwing it out to Colby Collins. At the St. John's line, he puts down the brakes, passes in front, and Brindleby intercepted. Then he lost it. Now it's Hannaford trying to center it out. He couldn't handle it. and Max Howell clears out to Gillis at center. He was turned around by Gesso, and Collins carries back. In with Gesso. Gesso gets out, and his shot's deflected to the corner. Right in front again, and Howell kicked it away. Golding had a long drive, went to the corner. Howell couldn't clear. On the line again, Gesso's shot. It was stopped by Gooby, and comes out to Sparrow at center. In over the Grand Falls line. He had a drive, and his backhander is kicked out by McGinnis. In the corner, Gesso gets to it. He couldn't clear. And then Sparrow lost it, and it rolled out over to center ice. It's Vern Gooby getting it there. Sparrow taking over, carries in with Gillis. Right in front of him, and he shoots, and he just missed the open side. And McGinnis was out of the net. Gillis holds it in, getting set, right in front. He had it on his goal! Ted Gillis, scoring for the Capitals. And the assist will probably go to Noel Sparrow and Mike Woodford. And St. John's is ahead in the Senior B Finals for the first time, leading the Grand Falls Bees by a score of 2-1. In Grand Falls territory, Cheryl Adney lost it on the boards to Colby Collins. The Capitals lead 2-1 with 40 seconds left in the first period. Collins then over the line. Flaherty stopped him. Then he was bumped on the boards by Clark. Alex Faulkner at center ice lets it go across to Cease Toms. He rolled it ahead and went over the boards, and they'll hold it for the faceoff. 28 seconds remaining in the first period with the score tied, St. John's 2 and Grand Falls 2. And Grand Falls playing a man shy with Siri Gesso in the box for a cross-checking penalty. The faceoff, Noel Sparrow fired it across on the wing. Woodford couldn't reach it. Max Howell rolled it ahead. Bucky Hannaford slammed it down the ice, and Vern Gooby got it and passed it ahead to Ted Gillis at the Grand Falls line. And he impounded his spell. Now it's Alec Faulkner starting out a breakaway, one man back. And he tried to steer it on the goal and went all the way around to Vern Gooby, who'll get the gate on that one with 5 seconds remaining in the first period. And Gooby will probably get a clipping penalty. So now they play five aside. The faceoff to the right of Merv Green. A big crowd at the stadium tonight. Certainly a capacity crowd. There were 3,000 seats sold in advance. The biggest advance sale the stadium's ever had. The faceoff in St. John's territory with 5 seconds left in the first period. Grand Falls change around and finally settle down with Vic Rion, Colby Collins, and Alec Faulkner on the forward line, and Thomas on the defense. The puck is dropped, and Lloyd Cook clears it to the line, but not out as Rion holds it in. Then Warren Englund shoots it out, and the horn goes to win the first period with the score all tied up. St. John's Capitals 2, the Grand Falls Senior Bees, the defending champions, 2. Shots on goal in the first period by St. John's 10 and by Grand Falls 9. There he is. Mike Woodford combines with Noel Sparrow, and it rolled in as Sparrow went tearing around the side of the net. So the Capitals lead it 3-2, and for the second time in the game, they're in front, and it's only the second time they've been ahead in the series. Noel Sparrow. The assist going to Mike Woodford at 3:05 of the second period. John 3, Grand Falls 2. And they jam it on the board to the left of the Capitals' goal and call it for a faceoff. Capitals, big line, their first line getting a big hand as they skate off the ice. The faceoff now to the left of Merv Green. Rayo, Faulkner, and Knight for Grand Falls. For the Capitals, Cyril Ivany, Rolly Clark, and Jack Withers. The faceoff, Faulkner flipped a high one, Len Coughlin caught it, then cleared it to the line, but not out. It's right in front again as Golding had a drive. It's steered behind the net, Coughlin gets it there and starts to bring it up on the wing. He tried to slip it out on the boards. It didn't work. And then Coughlin gets nice drive and couldn't clear it. In front again, it's Cyril Ivany. Rolling it ahead to Roller Clark. Gets center ice. Good Ivany in over the Grand Falls line. His pass was wide, and Knight clears it out on the far side. Party has it at center ice to Coughlin. Coughlin had a drive. It hit Ivany's leg and came out, and Coughlin gets it and carries it again over to Clark in the wing. The pass was behind him. Clark gets to it, loses it to Jim Temple. It's Temple at center, and his pass intercepted by Withers, who lets it go to Party. Party lost it again to Temple right in front. And he gets out, and it's knocked in as Brian came carrying in and hooked it right off Party's stick. So it's all tied up once more. Party. Brings it to the Grand Falls line. He couldn't hold on to it. It came out, and Woodford was trapped inside, and they call it. The hot face off, it's in Grand Falls territory. Golding cleared it, and Withers has it outside the line. He flips it in on the goal, and McGinnis stops it. And Thomas, with his slap shot, clears it down to the St. John's line where Party has it. Ahead to Withers. Withers flips it in over the line as the horn goes to end the second period with the score tied 3-3. And there have been some exciting moments here at the stadium tonight for this really big crowd for the third game of the Senior B Finals between the St. John's Capitals and the defending champion, Grand Falls Bees. The faceoff to the left of Sham McGinnis. It's Collins bringing it out in his own line. He gets to center ice, skating it over the St. John's line. He tried to center it. He did right in front. And Merv Green went down to stop that shot. From Bucky Hannaford, it's in front again. Sparrow taking it to his own line. That's center ice with Woodford and Gillis. Woodford put on the brace at the line, and he couldn't get the pass. Behind the goal, Sparrow again fighting for it. And Hannaford gets to it and brings it out. Max Howell deflected it to the side. Mike Woodford shooting it in again to the corner behind the goal. And Hannaford's in again to bring it out. At the line, it's Gillis getting it. Turns right in front of Sparrow. He couldn't get the shot away. At the line, it's Gooby bringing it in. On the wing, centers again. He fell back to Gooby, or rather Howell, and his shot hit a leg and went to the corner. In the corner again, it's Woodford fighting for it. He's knocked down, and Collins brings it out for Grand Falls. Skating hard over the St. John's line to the corner. Brings it around in front, flips it out. It rolls down the goal line, and it's cleared by Byrne Gooby of the Capitals. It was rolling right along the line. It's Lee Thomas in his own zone. Living up the center, it rolls all the way back into St. John's territory. Gooby couldn't clear it as Collins held it in. He and England fight for it right in front of the net. It's Gooby trying to clear again, and Green had to get down and stop it as the shot was deflected right on the corner of the goal. In the corner again, it's Woodford trying to clear. He's bumped right on the boards and goes down. There's a whistle on the play, and there'll be a penalty. The third period. And the penalties to Grand Falls, to Griot, a major, and to Neil Knight, a minor penalty, proved very costly indeed. And Ted Gillis collects his third goal of the night. And the face-off, it comes back to the St. John's line. Byrne Gooby rolls it ahead. He's knocked down. He's going behind the Grand Falls goal. There's a fan on the ice. A fan on the ice. And he's cross-checked by Bucky Hannaford and held on the ice. And the police come in. And the players all mill around as well. Now the police are struggling with the fan. And we believe he's the same fan that clipped Harvey House of Grand Falls, the defenseman, back in the first period, I believe it was, as he was skating by the boards. The police are trying to get the fan off the ice. He jumped on the ice and went after the Grand Falls player. That's to say, Clark Golding, when Vern Gulby was hit hard at the Grand Falls blue line. The fan leaning out over the boards, the police trying to get the handcuffs on the fan. And the first aid people out at center ice looking after Vern Gulby. Okay, now fessing up. Farrell at his own line gets to center ice, carries in over the Grand Falls line, chased by Foster. He's Farrell, and it's taken in the corner by Thomas. And there's a whistle on the play. It'll be a penalty to Grand Falls by himself. Nobody in the deep but McGinnis. Right in front. He shoots, and McGinnis kicks it out. A lovely save. And there's Temple starts back. One goes to end the game. And the Capitals win it 4-3, their first game of the Senior B Finals. And St. John's Capitals 4 and the Grand Falls Bees 3. Now we'll give you a rundown on the period, and while we're doing it, we'll let you have a look around at the crowd. The Capitals skating off the ice, and they had to play a whale of a game. The rundown on the scoring. While we're giving you a look at the tremendous crowd here tonight, we'll just pan around and look at the crowd and tell you that Ted Gillis scored 3 goals to lead the Capitals. Noel Sparrow got the other one. Lindy Faulkner, Colby Collins, and Vic Rio were the scorers for Grand Falls. The penalties in the game, we had a total of 15, 9 of which went to the defending champion Bees. There were 4 major penalties in the game. The rest were minors. The shots on goal in the first period, 10-5 in favor of the Capitals, 10-6.